An online jihadi who calls himself the Lone Wolf has been arrested in the United States today, about an hour before this program, on charges that he solicited the murder of members of the US military. Tonight, as part of an investigation into the radicalization on the social media site Tumblr, we can exclusively reveal who he is.
Greift die Kuffar an ihren eigenen Häusern. Tötet sie dort, wo ihr sie findet.
A call to arms from a German-speaking ISIS fighter for terrorist lone wolves to attack Europe. Jihadis who are a major source of concern for the West, outside of any command structure and off the radar. Tonight, Channel 4 News can reveal the identity of one of them, 23-year-old Terence Broadway from Akron, Ohio, who has called for the murder of his fellow Americans across social media. We believe he works at a hospital and wants to be a surgeon. While he may be working to help the sick, he recently actively encouraged ISIS supporters to kill US servicemen. And last year, this wannabe doctor indicated his willingness to take part in attacks.
I would gladly take part in an attack on this murderous regime and the people. I'll be proud when I slayed American blood. Somebody should park a car bomb in front of a church, school, or mall.
But these are more than idle threats. This is the address of Robert O'Neill, the Navy SEAL who claims to have killed Osama bin Laden, published by Terence Broadway earlier this month, who added a chilling message. But he has gone much further, encouraging attacks against dozens of US servicemen. Mr. Broadway published a kill list to his blog that appears to list the home addresses of 100 military personnel, people who the Pentagon was then forced to warn.
We decided to leak 100 addresses so that our brothers residing in America can deal with you.
Like many lone wolves, Terence Broadway's radicalization was sudden and impossible to track.
Intelligence services and law enforcement are struggling now most with trying to work out who is going to move from that realm of non-violent extremism to violent extremism. And where there used to be signs that they could follow, so international travel, attendance at a training camp, connections to a core jihadist group, particularly Al-Qaeda based in Pakistan and Afghanistan, that's not necessarily there anymore. And people can appear to turn on a moment.
It was forensic analysis of his Tumblr account that enabled Channel 4 News to chart his transformation. 5 years ago, he started blogging the sort of images you'd expect from any US teenager. But last year, something changed. From a mild interest in the Syrian civil war and Islamist ideology, increasingly he praised, promoted, and defended ISIS. A timeline of a few months that saw him swap his all-American stereotype for its jihadi nemesis. He was obsessed with Islamist lectures, many by British preachers. Mr. Broadway didn't respond to requests for comment and blocked Channel 4 News on Twitter. Late this evening, US authorities announced his arrest.
Our Washington correspondent Kylie Morris joins us now with the latest developments on that arrest.